In one of my videos, I talked about a direct TCP connection between you and your friend, so you could set up a multiplayer. That was all good, except something like that requires a lot of setup. You could have a router, you could have some router settings, or your OS, or some other third-party stuff might potentially block your connection. So in this video, I'm going to talk about one added layer, which is Steam. I have Steam running right now with Unity. The good thing about Steam is that most people can connect, and it doesn't require any additional setup most of the time. I'm going to press enter to start. I'm using an API called Facepunch. It's a C# version of Steamworks. I'm going to have all the links below so you can check them out, including this very project. So I'm going to start hosting the game. I've created a lobby. Now, this is a lobby that's created on Steam servers. So I'm going to go to Steam, go to my Steam application, and invite one of my friends. Invite to lobby. Now, this is just the other machine here. So I see the invite here. I'm going to play game. And as soon as I click play game, we're going to start joining the lobby. We get the handshake between server and client. Let me also go to my other machine. And from here, I can also do join game. Now I can join because the player that's hosting the server is on the friend list. So now we have three people on the server. I can chat, welcome to the server. Hello, everybody. Let me also go to the other machine and reply. I'm in. Let's play. Go, go, go. Let me also say something here. I'm a noob. We also see the list. The maximum number of people right now that I've set for the server is 10 people. We also see the profile names and stuff, the images and stuff. I'm going to click on start game, and the server's going to start the game and send the message to everyone. So you can see that the positions are synced, working nicely. Move around. What I'm doing here is sending P2P packets through Steam servers. Again, once you have a Steam connection, you're good to go. And using Steam, you can do all sorts of cool stuff like creating dedicated servers or creating a server hosted, a player hosted servers, or whatever. Green represents you, yellow represents the other players. And obviously, depending on who you are, you get different colors for different clients. You might have also noticed that I'm not, well, if you check out the repository, you might notice that I'm not using Unity assets like Photon or Mirror. That's just a personal choice. As far as I can tell, Mirror has pretty nice advanced netcode, but at the same time, sometimes you find yourself spending a lot of time finding the framework. I guess you can say the same thing about game engines, but you got to draw the line somewhere. So it's just a personal choice. Maybe later I'll talk about these decisions more in depth. For now, I'm happy enough with the results and move on. So this is just a sample. Next is putting my game on top of this and start sending and receiving a lot more than just positional data. So that's it for today. If you have any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. Have a great day.